who has been to a rural area recently, really outside and being there? Just hands up, please. So very, very few. So this talk is about rural areas, but to talk about rural areas, we need to look at the urban first. Obviously, today, everybody thinks the future is urban. So people move to urban areas. This year, we exceeded 50% of the total world population living in cities. Isn't that incredible? And now, instead of thinking this should end, this is terrible, we think, well, 2030, we have 70%. And I consider this nuts. So what do we do with that? We have areas where, on one hand, the urban, what happens there? Of course, there are upsides. So people go there to find a job, to have a social environment, to find friends, get married, whatever, go to the discotheque. But on the other hand, there is a lot of noise. You pay a fortune for a little flat that is just facing another flat across a noisy road. Where's your garden? So obviously, some things are wrong there. And so is that the lifestyle that we want for the future? Everybody, the only choice? I would say no. We need more choice, and that's what I want to talk about. Because there's one thing that worries me as a city dweller. If supplies would end, so big power cut, natural catastrophe, no supplies. I guess in around 2-3 hours, all shops will be sold out because everybody wants to get as much as possible to be prepared. And then the shops are empty and we don't know what to do. We don't know how we can survive. So in a city environment, we are mostly 100% dependent on outside supplies. Like a baby, huh? And now, the flip side of the urban life is that we have rural areas that are deserted more and more. People constantly move to the cities. People in the rural, they are old. No schools anymore. And at the same time, the rural areas, they have a type of farming that is using lots of chemicals, pesticides, toxic stuff. And this is something what will not have a future. We cannot pollute our groundwater further and further and further. We cannot destroy our soils because then we won't have water anymore. We need good soil to have water, as simple as that. But hardly anybody is looking at that. Do you hear a lot about soil? I guess not. It's our main crucial asset for the future. So now what happens? There are some good developments going on, and you all know about that. And that would be green development. So we have cities where people start to do urban gardening, rooftop garden, balcony garden, who is lucky has a little piece of land behind the house. So that is something I really like. And what I see that many people who are doing that, so transition town movement, for example, they want more. But that's impossible in the context of cities. So the urban can supply maybe 20% of the food with maximum urban gardening. It's good, but is that good enough? So what happens in the rural area on the positive side? There are some developments going on into ecological sound agriculture, organic agriculture. It's rising strongly on a worldwide scale, luckily, but at the same time it turns industrial. And in order to have real organic farms that keeping soil intact, building humus, we will need many, many people that live with farming. So is the type of farming that is done, is this ecological? It's not. Even the big organic farms are not really ecological if you look at it. And so what we need is attractive lifestyles in the rural that also do some farming, but not from morning to night, 7 days a week. I wouldn't like that. Many people on farms don't like that. The young guys leave the farm, as we see it everywhere, and another small farm going to the big one where one person works 3,000 hectare, probably with a robot machine in the future, nobody working there anymore. That has no future. And now what can we do? We must turn around the situation. So we need to put the urban into its place. Of course, we will have urban areas in the future, but not for all of the world population. So we need more attractive rural lifestyles. And that is what I think we should create now. And there is something where we could create something that we could call maybe new towns. The new town should have the positive sides of city life combined with the positive sides of rural life, having space, quiet areas, forest nearby, a lake where you can go swimming in the morning or a river. But combining that with job opportunities, having interesting people around, with the possibility to create your own things, not being like in city life, 100% dependent on somebody giving you a job, giving you a flat, providing a car, and so on. So how can that work? What would you think? How could the, well, dream town in the rural, not near the city where you go to the discotheque every day or commute to work, how could that village look like? How could that town look like? I don't know, but I have some ideas, and that's what I want to share with you. So one thing is that we have the social level, and that would be we should have sufficient numbers of people to make it attractive. Nobody wants to live alone in some remote rural area. Maybe few people might like that, but that's pretty much the exception. So we should have new towns that have maybe 100 to 500 people. And one thing that is crucial now is we should have productive towns that are producing high quality food, not only for themselves, but also for sale, for supplying the cities, in a way that is fun, leisure, and a good work-life balance, or work-work-work balance. And I'll explain you what I understand from that. So when we do a normal job, we normally work from morning to evening on the desk, or we do something sort of the same thing 5 hours a day, 5 days a week. And now we could balance. And in the morning, we could go and work with this thing. It's really fun. It's very efficient when you learn how to do it. And then we could go to the computer. Or something else, go to the workshop, create something, build this, for example, build a faith. And actually, I worked 30 years with computers, and I'm fed up. And so the life can be different, so we can do different things, balancing, and I don't mind working a third of my time on a computer, but not full time. Economy, so how can an economy look like? We need something where we need to reduce the costs of living. It's really difficult to survive in a rural area, far away from city, far away from supplies, from some government and so on. So reduce costs. The idea is to have a starter house, modular house that is small but very efficient, solar, passive solar, very well insulated but small for the beginning, so that young people moving out, they don't have a big debt in the bank, but with around, well, maybe 25,000 euros, they could own their own house and pay off the house plus maybe 3,000 square meters of land within 10 years' time. Own it completely. And that means that the, well, the retirement security is there because the land will stay and is productive. You can produce not only your own food, but you can supply 50 more people with 1/3 of a working day. That's the main thing. We don't want to get into this type of agriculture that we have today. So people who move out should be entrepreneurs, should be producers. They can produce, well, agricultural products, but with that we should have more jobs. And of course, there is jobs for childcare, teachers. There will be demand for tools, so somebody can build tools and run a company for producing that. Transportation, transporting the vegetables into the city with a bus maybe that people can also join. There is many, many, many options for that. So that is something that is well possible. Now we have the social, economic, and now the ecological level for the new town. And it would be a prerequisite that people do organic gardening, because only organic gardening can assure building up soil. The soil should become richer and richer, more productive every year. And that's a good asset for the future, for a good future for many, many people on the planet. We can have 100% of regenerative energy, and in fact, I could cook my meal on this wood gas stove. With local resources, this stove was produced in a town in Burkina Faso for 15 euros, all with waste materials from old fridges and so on. So also that is possible. And what is even better, the fuel comes from the waste, from the agriculture. This is made from reed and stuff and woody waste. And with that we can cook, and we could also produce electricity and so on. I don't want to go into details here, there's a lot available. Then we have one key issue that is often overlooked, and that is that we need a social environment where personal growth is, well, sort of promoted or possible. And there are wonderful tools for that. Without that, we have the same problems that we have today. So our society reflects lack of personal growth. And that's why we go into this dead-end road in many aspects. Now, this is something where we could come to something when we have, I said, 20% with green development, production of food. The new town could make 500%. So that would be exporters also having income from that. And then this whole context, this whole idea is sort of the post-industrialization development. The idea for people to move into cities came from there's factory, there's a job. And only then people started to gather in bigger and bigger numbers. And now this is not the case anymore. A lot of the production processes can be decentralized. Even in the new town, we can have somebody doing a high-tech production with 3D printers and things like that, if somebody wants to do that. It's an option. So we get freedom. And with that, we have something where we have a definition of wealth that is from Amartya Sen, Nobel Prize winner of the Nobel Prize of Economy. And he has defined wealth as the degree of freedom that we obtain. So having a job 12 hours a day, being burned out every weekend, is not very much wealth with this definition. So let's go for a future with lots of wealth, where we have the freedom to choose what we want to do, where we have diversity of things that can be done. We should move into a region that is attractive, having forests, mountains, or a lake, a river, so that it's really a place to be, where people love to be, and at the same time being productive And that is something what I think is part of the model for our future. And now my final question to you. Who can imagine to live in a new town like that? Please, hands up. Okay, that convinces me, and I hope you will join for this development. Thank you very much.